Hi kids, welcome back to GraviCalc, where each week we build a new digital logic circuit out of marbles. We're doing this to learn how computers and other electronics work on the inside. This is the eighth lesson in the series, and today we're going to switch gears and actually do some arithmetic with a Gravitrax marble run. In case you're new to my channel, I'm the Masked Marble, and my videos are about all things Gravitrax. It's summer here in Tucson, and the temperature has been well over 100 degrees Fahrenheit this past week. That's why I wear a hat, because it's important to get shade from the intense rays of the sun. Just as scripture says that our God is a consuming fire, the sun is itself a burning ball of gas whose energy would consume us if we were exposed to its full intensity. Thankfully, we have the Earth's atmosphere and the geomagnetic field, and the shade of buildings and trees and cowboy hats all working together to protect us from the sun's fierce rays. And thankfully, we have the sacrifice of Jesus to protect us from our Creator's fierce anger against our sins, an anger which, according to the Bible, will one day cause the heavens to pass away with a great noise and the elements melt with fervent heat. The earth and all the works of mankind will be burned up. Then God will make a new heaven and a new earth, one that is not subject to the curse that fell on the earth as a result of Adam and Eve's rebellion against God. And the new earth will be large enough to host a city built by God that is over 2,200 kilometers tall. That is a much larger planet than our current planet Earth. Remember that in the first part of the series, we built seven simple logic gates. Then, over the past two lessons, we learned to count in binary numbers, also called the base 2 number system, which is the number system computers use. Today, we'll use everything we've learned so far by combining two gates together today to build a computer adding machine that can add binary numbers. So if you haven't watched the previous lessons, you'll want to watch them first. In the last lesson, we built a pretty cool computer counting machine that counts to 15. Like last week, today's track requires two Gravitrax starter sets to build. I almost got the design down to a single starter set, but unfortunately, Gravitrax starter sets only contain one splash insert, and we need two. Build today's track by loading the Gravitrax app code below into the free Ravensburger GraviTrax app. Then switch to manual mode to get the build instructions. Now go ahead and pause the video and build the track. In the last two lessons, we used switches to represent zeros and one. Today we're going to switch back to the previous convention of using marbles to represent zeros and ones. A marble in an input slot or an output landing pad represents a 1, and a lack of a marble represents a 0. Before we start running marbles, let's take a quick look around the track. At the top, we have our launch pad. The bottom two slots of the launch pad are going to be the two binary numbers we're adding. These are the two inputs for this track. This track can only add single-digit binary numbers, or at most it can add 1 plus 1. But don't worry, next week we'll figure out how to add larger numbers. At the bottom of the track, we have two logic gates, an XOR gate on the right and an AND gate on the left. And because we need both inputs going to both gates, we have two splash pads, which we use to turn each input marble into two input marbles, one that goes to the logic gate on the right and one that goes to the logic gate on the left. Lastly, look at the bottom. We have two landing pads, one on the left and one on the right. The adding machine we're building today is called a half adder. It adds two binary digits. We'll talk about why it's called a half adder in a minute. Let's think about what we need to do to add two binary digits. We're going to figure out why we're combining an AND gate and an XOR gate in our circuit. Let's make a logic table where we add input A and input B together. Both inputs are single-digit numbers or single bits. They can each hold a 0 or a 1. So here's a question. If we add inputs A and B together, what's the highest sum we could possibly get? Well, 0 plus 0 is 0, and 1 plus 0 is 1. 0 plus 1 is 1, and 1 plus 1 is 2. Remember from our last two lessons that in binary we can't put a 2 in the 1's place, so we have to carry it to the 2's place. We write the number 2 in the binary number system as 10, which is a 2-bit number. In a binary adder, we call the digit on the left the carry bit because it carried over, and the digit on the right the sum bit. When we add 0 plus 0 or 1 plus 0, the carry bit is 0. But when we add 1 plus 1, the carry bit is 1. Let's look at the sum bit and ignore the carry bit for a second. Say, this looks a lot like a logic table for one of the logic gates we built in the first 5 lessons. Do you remember which logic gate gives you a 0 if both inputs are 0, and 1 if either input is 1, and a 0 if both inputs are 1? That was an XOR gate. An exclusive OR gate was like if Dad said, "Where do you want to eat, Chick-fil-A or Habit Burger?" You could choose one restaurant or the other, but not both to eat at. So with an XOR gate, you'll remember the output is 1 if either input is 1, but not if both inputs are 1. So the sum bit in our logic table behaves just like an XOR gate. In our adding machine, we built an XOR gate on the right above our sum bit landing pad. Now let's look at the carry bit and ignore the sum bit. This looks a lot like the logic table for another logic gate we have built. We get a 0 if both inputs are 0, and also if either input is 1. But if both inputs are 1, the output is 1. This is the logic table for an AND gate. The output is only 1 if input A and input B are 1. So the carry bit in our logic table behaves just like an AND gate. In our adding machine, we built an AND gate on the left above our carry bit landing pad. Here is what the logic diagram for our adding machine looks like. It takes two inputs on the left, which are input A and input B, and routes each input to both logic gates. Do you see how the lines on the left have a dot where they cross? In an electrical circuit, this means the input wires are connected together, which means the input signal gets split and sent to both of the gates on the right. The XOR gate on top takes input A and input B and outputs the sum bit. And the AND gate on the bottom takes input A and input B and outputs the carry bit. This circuit is called a half adder. Why is it called that? Because a full adder needs to add 3 bits. When you add larger binary numbers than 1 plus 1, the larger place values have to add 2 numbers as well as the carry bit from the previous place value. When you add 2 bits, A and B, together with a carry bit, that's 3 bits that need to be added together. So a full adder adds 3 binary bits. A half adder cannot add a carry bit from a previous place value. It can only add the 2 inputs, A and B. So the half adder circuit we built today is a computer that can only add up to 2. Next week, we'll build a full adder that can add 3 bits, and we'll do it with a single starter set, making a computer that can count up to 3, or that can add up to 3. Then in the following lesson, we'll cascade 2 full adders, resulting in a computer that can add up to 7. For that lesson, you'll need 2 starter sets. Though you won't need them, a volcano and a scoop will also be super handy if you have them. Using volcanoes and scoops, you can make an adding computer that is only limited by the number of starter sets you own. So let's run the track. Each time we run the track, make sure your splash pads have marbles on the bottom, and make sure your switches are correctly reset. First, let's run the case where there is no marble in either input A or input B. Zero plus zero equals zero, so we get a zero in the carry bit landing pad on the left, and also a zero in the sum bit landing pad on the right. Pretty boring, right? Now let's put a marble in input A and leave input B with no marble. So that means we're going to add 1 plus 0. Go ahead and run the track. When we add 1 plus 0, we get 0 in the carry bit and 1 in the sum bit. So the answer is 1. Now reset the track and let's put a marble in input B and leave input A with no marble. So that means we're going to add 0 plus 1. Go ahead and run the track. When we add 0 plus 1, we get 0 in the carry bit and 1 in the sum bit, so the answer is also 1. Now here's where the adding computer really shines. Reset the track and put a marble in both input A and input B. Now run the track. When we add 1 plus 1, the answer is 2, which is a 1-0 in binary. So we should have a 1 in our carry bit landing pad and a 0 in our sum bit landing pad. In the half adder, the carry bit is the 2's place value, and the sum bit is the 1's place value. Believe it or not, there is a simpler way to implement an adding circuit in Gravitrax than combining an XOR gate with an AND gate. When we build a full adder next week, we won't need to split the inputs and send them to two gates. So next week you'll be able to build the track with a single starter set. And the resulting marble computer is a lot of fun to run. We'll see you next week.
Yes, last week you were able to best our math teacher. You're obviously a genius, since you answered every question correctly on your math test in the base one number system. Somehow you knew that in the base one number system, the only number that exists is zero. So let's move on to theology. I bet you won't do as well in this subject. How many humans did God consult with before creating the cosmos?
Zero.
To how many people does God owe proof of his existence?
Zero.
How many people possess the inherent right to judge their creator?
Zero.
How many people can wash away the stain of their own sin?
Zero.
Besides Jesus, how many other sacrifices did God provide to cleanse humankind of their sin?
Zero.
How many people get a vote in this?
Zero.
In how many areas of human enterprise would it be justifiable to exclude the God who created all of our human faculties through which those enterprises find their realization?
Zero.
Very good. Maybe we should skip you ahead a few grades. At what time can we dismiss for lunch?
Zero.